So after seeing Star Wars video, I'm keeping that one. So after seeing Star Wars Theory's recent video on how there's this huge debate and controversy over the fact that Dave Filoni had stated that Anakin Skywalker was the greatest Jedi of all time, I thought I'd come on here and actually address why that's absolutely true, and you guys should absolutely go check out his video on this topic, because it was actually a pretty good video. To explain how he is the greatest Jedi ever, let's ask the question of what even is a Jedi? Well, we know they aren't a police or military force, right?
We're keepers of the peace, not so.
Well, they aren't, well, let's have George explain it.
Jedi are like negotiators. They aren't people that go out and blow up planets. They aren't people that shoot down things. They're more of a one-to-one combat type. I just want the form of fighting and the role of the Jedi Knight to be special and more spiritual and more intellectual than just a fighter or a superhero or something like that.
All right, now that we know what a Jedi is supposed to be, let's analyze that in a very Star Wars way. Star Wars, for those who don't know, borrows heavily from mythologies around the world. Not inspired, but literally referencing it.
What do you make of the fact that so many people have interpreted Star Wars as being profoundly religious?
I don't see Star Wars as profoundly religious. I see Star Wars as taking all of the issues that religion represents and trying to distill them down into a more modern, more easily accessible construct that people can grab onto to accept the fact that there is a greater mystery out there.
Well, which religion slash mythology has anything in common with a Jedi? I would say Buddhism, but specifically Mahayana Buddhism. Just to quickly explain what Mahayana Buddhism is, it is a certain sect within Buddhism that, and their particular belief is that all life, not just the gods and humans, but like all life, including the demons, which demons in the East mean something very different than demons in the West, are capable of walking the path of Buddha, therefore nirvana slash absolute enlightenment, and leading others in that same path while you walk the same as well. Obviously, that is not the only mythological idea that the idea of Jedi is grabbed from, but it is most likely the basis, as this idea is seen throughout many cultures and religions around the world for thousands of years. Okay, so Jedi are peace negotiators that need to lead others on that same path of whatever enlightenment means for the Star Wars universe. So, what is enlightenment in the Star Wars universe?
You live in two worlds here. Happiness is pleasure, and happiness is joy. You know, it can be either one. You add them up and it sort of falls under the uber category of happiness. Pleasure is short-lived. It lasts an hour, lasts a minute, lasts a month. And it peaks and then goes down. It peaks very high. But the next time you want to get that same peak, you have to do it twice as much. You know, it's like drugs. You know, just you have to keep doing it because it insulates itself. No matter what it is, whether you're shopping, whether you're, engaged in any other kind of pleasure, that all has the same quality about it. On the other hand is joy, and joy is a thing that doesn't go as high as pleasure in terms of your emotional reaction, but it stays with you. Joy is something you can recall. Pleasure, you can't. So the secret is that even though it's not as intense as the pleasure, the joy will last you a lot longer. If you're trying to sustain that level of peak pleasure, you're doomed. Peak, great. Pleasure is fun. It's great. But you can't keep it going forever. Just accept the fact that it's here and it's gone. And maybe again it'll come back and you'll get to do it again. Joy lasts forever. Pleasure is purely self-centered. It's all about your pleasure. It's about you. It's a selfish, self-centered emotion that's created by a self-centered motive of greed. Joy is compassion. Joy is giving yourself to somebody else or something else. And it's a kind of thing that is, in its subtlety and lowness, much more powerful than pleasure. If you get hung up on pleasure, you're doomed. If you pursue joy, you will find everlasting happiness.
awesome. Jedi are intended to walk the path of the pursuit of joy and actively negotiate or encourage others to make those same pursuits. Now, finally, we know the basis of what makes a Jedi a Jedi. Well, good question. Has Anakin Skywalker ever tried to pursue joy and actively encourage others to walk the same path? Well, he is the chosen one who brought balance to the Force by bringing an end to the Sith. But let's look into that, because people try to say that Anakin was not the chosen one because he became a Sith, bringing an imbalance to the Force by there being no prominent Jedi to balance the Sith. First off, the Force being balanced is not dependent on the number of Jedi versus Sith, or light users versus dark users. As explained earlier by Lucas, dark side users pursue the ultimate pleasure and the ultimate goal to be an enlightened soul, an idea separated from any faction or light versus dark, is to pursue joy. But I hear you typing, how does Anakin then bring balance to the Force if he became a dark side user who pursued pleasure at its utmost?
You gotta remember, this is one movie, and it's meant to be seen 1 through 6. So I think when you watch the actual movie in order, the story will become very clear that Anakin is the chosen one.
You refer to the prophecy of the one who will bring balance to the Force. You believe it's this boy?
And even when Anakin turns into Darth Vader, he is still the chosen one. The prophecy is that Anakin will bring balance to the Force and destroy the Sith. He becomes Darth Vader. Darth Vader does become the hero. Darth Vader does destroy the Sith, meaning himself and the Emperor. He does it because he is redeemed by his son.
Well, on Vader's final day, his son, Luke Skywalker, was able to give confidence to the ever-so-shallow Anakin that was inside of him for the entire time. So Anakin killed the first Sith in the room, that being himself. He had to destroy himself to recreate himself, not only in this scene, but the scene right after, which is sort of a play on the Phoenix, which you'll see a lot in Star Wars. Back to Anakin, he then destroys the second Sith in the room, Darth Sidious, Palpatine, the man responsible for seducing Anakin to the dark side, literally Satan himself. But by doing so, as mentioned before, he destroys his current Sith body, recreating his true image as a Jedi, truer than we had ever seen before that point. Because he pursued the ultimate joy, and in that one moment fulfilled the prophecy of the Chosen One. Okay, that's awesome and all, but how does he negotiate or encourage others to walk the path of joy? Well, he not only continues to do this with his son Luke Skywalker as a Force ghost, but even as Vader, Anakin encouraged Luke not to kill him. Maybe not directly himself, maybe he didn't exactly state it from his mouth, but Luke, after being told that Vader is his father, and Luke learning about Anakin Skywalker, Luke identified himself with his father, not Vader, but Anakin. So, in turn, Luke went to attempt to turn him to the light side once more, the catalyst he needed. So, Anakin's dark side caused him to go back to the light side from a certain point of view, again, playing on the whole Phoenix thing. Yes, he is the greatest Jedi of all time. He became the personification of what any Jedi would ever hope to become. His son, Luke, is the closest that anyone had ever came to up until that point. Well, that was a fun short video. I hope you learned something new, and if you like this style of content, I'm currently working on a series on how Star Wars, Dragon Ball, and mythologies in general are all intertwined, and it'll be really interesting. It's called Rings Within Rings. And you can watch the trailer by either clicking the I in the corner right now, or in the description of this video. Also, in the description, you'll also find my Twitter where you can catch any updates on videos, and you'll also find some other noteworthy links. But with all that aside, have a nice day.